Sometimes it seems that dinosaurs are just about everywhere, in films, books, comics, and even theme parks. And with the help of the Dinosaur Whisperer and his team, we try to untangle dino fact from fiction in our continuing feature, The Dinosaur Show. Here's a look.
Hi, my name is Dustin, and I love dinosaurs. Hi, I'm Dustin.
And I'm Zach.
And we love dinosaurs. That was pretty good. That worked out pretty well. High five.
What is a dinosaur?
That's a really good question, Zach. That is a great question. Especially for the first episode of a show that's all about dinosaurs, we should probably establish exactly what is a dinosaur. Dinosaurs were the first group of animals that completely abandoned life in the seas. They're the first animals to be like, you know what? Peace out, ocean. I'm going to live exclusively on land. The first habitually terrestrial animals on planet Earth. So, in order to determine what is a dinosaur and what isn't a dinosaur, it's kind of similar to determining what is a cat and what is not a cat. The taxonomists are scientists that classify groups of organisms based on shared characteristics. And that's kind of how we know when we see like a puma or an ocelot, even if we've never seen it before, we can pretty much figure out that's a member of the cat family.
The fur, the four legs, the tail, the teeth.
Ears.
The habitat.
So, taxonomists and paleontologists classify dinosaurs as dinosaurs based on certain shared characteristics. And there's a whole suite of these, the most important of which are probably certain positioning of holes in the skull, vertebral morphology, being basically just a fancy science word for shape. Dinosaurs were the first group of animals that put their legs directly under their body. They have a ball and socket joint in their pelvis that allows their legs to come straight down under their body. If you are a crocodile or an alligator, or most reptiles, you got your arms splayed out to the side. You're kind of inefficiently locomoting with a side-to-side movement that's kind of reminiscent of when they used to live in water and they had fins that needed to be pushing water from side to side. So dinosaurs were like, peace out, I'm going on land. It's not gonna be very efficient for me to move if I have legs splayed to the side, kind of doing this weird side-to-side motion. So
sounds exhausting.
It is, I've tried it once for an entire day. So you put your legs directly under your body. It's much more easy, not only just to stand here, does it take a lot of energy right now?
No,
you just got to balance. And then when it comes time to move, when it comes time to locomote, you can do it much more efficiently and move a lot faster. But that's not the only thing that makes a dinosaur a dinosaur. Do you want to know what else makes a dinosaur and you not a dinosaur?
Yes.
Of course you do. And that brings us to the thing of the week. According to our flowchart, are you a dinosaur? Step one, are your legs directly under your body?
Yes.
Yes, legs are directly under your bodies. All right, check. Big check. Step two, scales or feathers?
No.
I don't think so either. No scales, no feathers, not a dinosaur. Sorry, man.
So anything that has its legs directly underneath its body,
yes,
and scales or feathers,
yes,
is a dinosaur.
Everything that I have found. If you can find something that disproves this flowchart, please let me know. Can you think of an animal that just happens to have their legs directly on their body, but does have scales or feathers?
Birds.
Birds. Absolutely right. But that's a whole nother topic for a whole nother episode.